At the age of 3, I fell in a ditch, and from my severe injuries, I was told I would not live very long. Today, I am celebrating my 80th birthday and would like to tell you my story. My name is Shanti Kumari Bhatia. I was born on October 23, 1938, in Shujabad, District Multan, now in Pakistan. During partition in 1947, we had to leave Pakistan. My father had to move to different towns in India to find work. Purushottam Das Bhatia, my Mamaji, was a visionary. We used to call him Lalaji. He bought over 800 acres of land in Jugrunagar near Nainital with a couple of friends to start a farm that would help refugee families live a life of dignity. My family also moved to Bhatia Farmers Cooperative Society in 1950. My father was a very good administrator and he brought new ideas to grow the farm and make it profitable for the shareholders. My mother was the go-to person for the whole community. Growing up on the farm was a lot of fun. I had 5 brothers and sisters and so many children to play with. I learned swimming, singing, embroidery and cooking from my mother, Shilvati, a very talented and smart lady. Even though I was always quite sick as a child, my father, Seth Ramnarayan Bhatia, and Lalaji always encouraged me to study. At the age of 16, I completed high school but could not go to the city to attend college like my siblings because of my health. But I was determined to study further. I got books and studied by myself. Then I went to Bareilly to take exams. I received a bachelor degree and 2 master's degrees, one in Sanskrit and the other in Hindi from Agra University. While I was studying, I also started teaching and managing the village school. I was a career working woman at the age of 16. I loved teaching and even today, my students call me on Teacher's Day to thank me. Seeing them do so well in life makes me feel proud. Subhash had heard about me from mutual friends. We met in Muradabad and he wanted to marry me right away. In 1975, I was 36 at that time and I had started wearing white clothes from the age of 21. And I was leading a sannyasi type of life. I was not mentally ready for this, but then my father and Lalaji convinced me. Within 2 hours, I was married. After 9 months, I came to Lancaster, Ohio, where my husband had lived for the last 14 years. Nothing was familiar to me, but singing was my passion. from childhood, and that helped me connect with the Indian American community and settle in. Subhash did not want me to work because he wanted me to be with him always. So we traveled together wherever his job took him. In 1978, my right kidney was removed. All the doctors told me that I may never conceive. In 1981, the most unexpected thing happened. I could not believe my eyes that I was holding my own baby. Shivani was a bundle of joy. I took Subhash and her to the farm in Jugrunagar. They had a lot of fun, taking bullock cart ride, using the hand pump to get water, going to the sugarcane farm, climbing haystacks, and enjoying the rural life. In 1990, my husband's failing health led us back to India so that in his final days, he could enjoy himself with family and his old friends. But Subhash's health improved, and when Shivani was 17, I wanted her to attend college in the US, so we came back in 1998 and Subhash followed us. I started working again to support the family, mainly to get health care coverage. Shivani went to Ohio State University and excelled in her studies. She graduated in 2003 in Management Information Systems and decided to move to East Coast for career opportunities. 1 year later, Subhash passed away. Shivani, not wanting us to live apart, bought a condo for us in New Jersey. I was 67 when I moved to New Jersey. As always, my first stop was the library. That helped me connect with the community. Even as I was dealing with health issues, in 2006, I helped start a non-profit to assist other seniors that I continue to work with even today. In 2016, I was fortunate enough to receive from President Obama the President's Award for my volunteer work. Depression and excuse, these two words have never been in my vocabulary. All through my life, I met the nicest people in the world who have always supported me. I get mad at God, but not on people. I'd like to tell my children and their children to never let an excuse stand in their way. Find another way.